Guys, when you have fans like all of these out here, that means you have followers. So in his time of need, Randall King turned to social media. Randall King Band is used to arriving at gigs in a tour bus hauling a trailer like this. But tonight, the band arrived to Hot Country Nights in one pickup, their gear in another. After playing last night in St. Louis, they were 70 miles from Kansas City when their tour bus broke down.
It just completely broke down. I mean, there's oil all over the trailer, and we're like, well, we're stuck.
King posted on Twitter they need help getting to the show.
And it had only been up like 5 or 6 minutes, so I immediately jumped on Twitter, and I was off of work, so figured, what the heck, I'll shoot him a direct message, and we'll go from there.
Matt Hinckley had seen 6 shows and met King once before. Now he was on his way from Kansas City to pick up the band, but they still needed someone to haul their trailer full of gear. Tim Allen is a Mexico-Missouri musician. A friend saw the post and knew he could help.
I've definitely been broke down before and had some people help me, so always try and return the favor.
A couple hours behind schedule, the band was on the road.
Yeah, I tried not to fangirl too much. I mean, again, you listen to somebody a lot, and you respect their music, and there they are sitting in your passenger seat. It's pretty cool.
And on the stage, in the midst of a tour where sometimes it's easy to get lost in which city is next. Tonight's show, one neither the band or a couple of Kansas City area fans will soon forget.
Well, that's the beauty of this country, man. People are just so friendly, so kind, and you know, the dude drove 70 miles this way, 70 miles back, and I mean, it's, thank God we have people like that in this country.
Power of social media, I guess.
Absolutely. Now, Cody Johnson is about to take the stage. Randall King just wrapped their set. That means they're on their way out of here. I'm told they're working on the bus. They have a show tomorrow night in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and they say they will be there one way or another. Dave DeMarco, Fox 4 News.